Good afternoon. Course title, Compiler Design, Course Code CS451, and the topic is Intermediate Code Generation. In the last class, we already discussed some of the points, benefit of the code, intermediate code generation, intermediate language, syntax tree, postfix, type checking. There are two types of type checking, static and dynamic. And what is the difference between the static and dynamic type checking? Intermediate language and the three address codes. In the three address codes, what are the advantage of the three address codes and the implementation of the three address codes? And we know that there are three representations, quadruples, triples, and the indirect triples. In the last class, I represent all these three with the example. With the advantage and disadvantage, then the semantic analysis, need of the semantic analysis, type checking, type expressions, type simple type checkers. These topics we already covered in the last class. Today we will discuss about the three address code declaration. First, see type of the three address statements. Procedure calls, it means PARF, these are the parameters, and we call the procedure, then the procedure will return the value. And means functions, subroutines, these are the procedure calls, the parameter x1, x2, xn are used as parameters to the procedure p, and it will return the value y. Next is the array, same type of value, it is stored. X is y, I, here I is the index. Xi equal to y, we know the concept of array. Address and pointer assignments, we know about the pointer and their and using the pointer we can also assign the value. So we can assign the value. Assignment statements, x equal to y operator z. So here binary operation perform using the operator op. Assignment statements, x equal to op y, this means op means this is the unary operation. Suppose you want to represent the value +5 -5, here this plus and this minus, this is the op. Then code copy, x equal to y, it means the value of y is assigned to x. Unconditional jumps, we know that go to is the unconditional loop. Here go to n means the control flow goes to the statement labeled by l. This is the conditional jump, it means if x, it means relational operator y go to n. Here x relational operator y, then this will return the value true and false. So if the value is the true, then go to n, it means here l is the label. Next is the generation of three address code declaration. Here SD offset 0. Next is the enter tab. The means of here enter tab, here tab is the function. Here tab is the function used to create the simple table entry for the identifier id.name with its type and offset. So here offset equal to offset plus width. Here now suppose t is integer, then t type integer, and we know that suppose the width of the integer is 4, so t width equal to 4. If the value is real floating point, then t type equal to real, and suppose the width is t, suppose the width is 8, so we can represent t dot width equal to 8. Here t equal to array num of t1. We know what is the means of this. Here this is the num, it means now suppose and a 10, it means this can store 10 value of the same type. So here t type equal to array num dot val and t1 dot type. So we can calculate the width by multiplying the num dot val equal to t1 dot width. This is the pointer, and suppose the pointer is, and its type is integer, so its width is t dot width equal to 4. So here initially the value of the offset is 0, so the computation of offset is done using the formula offset equal to offset plus width. Here t width and t type is the synthesized attributes, so the type indicates the data type and width indicates the memory units associated with the identifier of the corresponding type. Id.t is the declarative statement for id declaration. Enter tab is the function for creating the simple table entry for the identifier along with its type and width, and its type and offset. The width of the array is obtained by multiplying the width of each element of the number of the element in the array. And suppose the width of the pointer type is supposed to be 4. So this is the explanation of the previous reproductions. Next is the generation of the three address code for the assignment statement. We know that these are the assignment statements. Here as id.e, here id entry equal to lookup id.name. If id entry is not equal to null, then append id entry equal to e place else error. So for the generation of the semantic action of this production, here we are using the functions. One function is the lookup function, next function is the append function. See what is the means of the lookup. The lookup return the entry for id name in the symbol table if it exists there. The function append for appending the three address code to the output file, otherwise it will report an error. New tab is the function for creating a creating a new temporary variables. Keep.place is used to hold the value of e. See in this, here we are using these four. One is the lookup functions. It will look the value of this id name in the simple table. If id entry is not equal to null, then append id entry equal to ePlace. Then append, it will append the value of ePlace in the table. Then next is e1.evenPlace plus e2. Here this is again the new temp function. The use of this new temp function is the function for generating a new temporary variable. So here we are using the this, it will e.place, it will create a new temporary variables, and the value of e.place is placed in the, is appended in the table e1.place plus e2.place. Like this, here this is the multiplier. So here we are using the multiplier. E is minus e1, this is the unary minus. So here ePlace, so this is the new temporary variables, and the value of this is appended in this way. E.place equal to e1.place, this is clear. Again for the identifier, again it will look in the symbol table. If id entry is not equal to null, then append the entry, append id entry equal to ePlace, otherwise it will give the error. Next is the assignment, next is the Boolean expression. Here we know that here this is the OR, this is the AND, this is the NOT. So here E equal to E1 or E2. Then E place equal to new time, same function, it will create the value. And here the operation is OR, so it compute or it append the value of E.place by e1.place or e2.place. Same here we are using AND operator, so AND operation. Here NOT, so NOT. Then e.place equal to e1.place, e equal to id1, relational operator id2, e.place equal to new temp, it create a new temporary variables e.place. Then this is the code. Now see the code with this example. Now suppose example P is greater than Q and R is less than S or U is less than B. See how can you write the code 100 if P is greater than Q, go to 103. Next state plus 3. Go to next state plus 3. 100 plus 3, 103. See what is 101. So that is the T1 equal to 0. 102. Go to 104. 103. T1 equal to 1. Next. 104, if R is less than S, go to 107. 105, T2 equal to 0. 106, go to 108. 107, T2 equal to 1, 108. If 9, T3 equal to 0, 1, 1, 0, go to 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, T3 equal to 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, so that is the here AND and OR. Here we are using the two Boolean expressions, or here we are using the two relational operators AND and OR. Which operator has the highest priority? We know that AND operator has the higher precedence. So T4 equal to T1 AND T2, then 1, 1, 3, T5 equal to T4 or T3. In this way, we can write the statement for these expressions. Here, append E dot value equal to 0, false, and append, go to next state plus 2, append E dot place equal to 1. Here, this is the next state plus 3. Then, for the false value, next state plus 2, and then this E dot E is true, so append E place equal to 1 for the true value. If the value is false, then E place equal to 0. So in this way we can represent the production with the symbolic actions. Next is the flow of controls. Next is the flow control, flow of controls. So these are the statements for the flow of control. One, as if E, if simple if statements, then if else statements, and this is the while loop, do while loop. Here, now see the means of these statements. Here, as if E then S1, E dot true, it creates a new label. Here we are using if function, new label, E false, S code, E code. See the meaning of this. To generate a new symbolic label, we have a function, new label, with the expression E true and E false are the label associated. S code and E code are the generating three address code. This symbol is used for the concatenation, the string, the function GENCODE is used to evaluate the non-coded argument passed to it and the concatenate and concatenate the complete string. The S code is the important rule which ultimately generates the three address code. See, this, how can you represent this? E code here it will generate E dot true, E dot false. It generates these two labels E true and E false. For this E true, E true, the code is S1 code. The code is S1 code, and for the E false, these are the. This simple. The statement is like this: if A is greater than B, then this statement. It means the if the value it returns the true value, then this S1 statement is executed. For this E dot true, if it generates the true value, then E dot true equal to this S1 code is generated. So here E dot true equal to new label, it create a new label E false S next. S next, S1 next equal to S next, same. S code equal to E code concatenate with the generate code E true at that label, at this, and S1 code. This code is executed. In this way, we can represent the simple if statement, if then statement. Now, suppose the next is if else. E dot code again E true, E false, E false, then E true S1 dot code go to S next, then S2 code, this is the E false, and this is anti the other. Here, then, so this is the jump from this to this. Here, S next means go to this next table, S next table, then these codes are executed. Here, E code, it will generate the true value or the false value. So, what is the code for the true value and what is the code for false value? If the value is true, then these codes generated, otherwise this code. So we can write the semantic actions in this way: E true equal to new label, false new label, S1 next is S next. In this way we can write the code for this. Next is now see the example for this statement. If A is less than B, then A equal to A plus 5, else A equal to A plus 7. So what is the code for this? Write in this way: 100, if A is greater than B, go to hello. Then 101, go to 103. Then what is for this 102? If this is true, then label is L1. So here A equal to A plus Then next is 1 0. For this 1 0 3, so that is the s part. So here a equal to a plus. So this is the code for this statement. Next is the while. Next is the while. While here this is the s begin. Here this is the e code. Again it will generate the value e true, e false. Then this is the s1 code for this e2. Then go to s dot begin. Go to s dot begin. It will move here, and e dot false is the statement for the e dot false. See the example. Now suppose the statement is like this. While generate the 3 address codes for while I is less than 10, x equal to 0, I equal to I plus 1. Then how can we write the code? If 100, first is s begin. So first we create a label L1. In this label, if I is less than 10, go to L2. Go to L2. Then this is the 101. Go to L next. Next is 102. L2. So that is the, you go to L2, then these two statements are executed. X is 0, 103. This is I equal to I plus 1. Next is 104. Go to L1. Go to L1. 105. L next. So here, now compare with this s dot begin. What is s dot begin? S dot begin equal to L1. S dot begin equal to new label. So that is L1. This is L1. E dot to equal to new label. This is L2. This is L2. Then E false equal to E code. What is E code? E code is this. If if I is less than 10, go to. This is the E code. Then what is the E false? E false equal to S next. So here this is the L next. Then what is the S code? S code is X equal to 0 and L I equal to I plus 1. So these are the S code. Next is the case statement. Switch case statement. We know about the switch case statements from the programming language. Here the statement says switch E. Here is the expression, is the value of this expression is V1. These statements are executed. Then V2, S2 executes up to Vn, then Sn minus 1 executes, and the default is this. So here now we can write the code for the switch case statements. So what is the actions for the semantic actions for the switch case statements? We can represent this using the if statements like this. If t equal to v1, go to l1, t2, go to l2, then t vn minus 1, then go to ln minus 1, default is ln, so here go to ln, and this way we can write. Now see the example of the switch case statement generating the three address code for the switch CH case 1, C equal to A plus B, break case 2, C equal to A minus B, break, and this is the end. Now what is the procedure to write the code semantic actions using the if statements? If ch equal to 1, go to L1. This is the 100. Next, 101. If ch equal to 2, go to L2. Then 102. L1. So what is L1? C equal to A plus B. C, for this C we can use a temporary variable, that is the T1 A plus B. Then 103, C equal to T1. 104, go to last. This is last. 105, L2 is T1 equal to A minus B, temporary variable. Then 106, C equal to, then in this way we can write the code. And next is the last, 107, go to last. So in this way we can write the semantic actions for this or the we can write the three address code for this switch case statement. Next is bell patching. The easiest way to implement the SDD for the Boolean expression is to use the two passes. The main problem for generating for the Boolean expression for the flow of control statement in a single pass is that during one single pass we may not know the level that control must go to the to at the end of at the time the jump statements are generated. Hence, a series of branch statements with the target of the jump left unspecified is generated. Each statement will be put on a list of go-to statements whose labels will be filled in when the proper label can be determined. We call this subsequent filling of the label bell patching. See the definition. You can write the definition in this way. Backpatching is the activity of filling up unspecified information of the label using the appropriate semantic actions in during the code generation process. For the manipulation of the labels, we use the three functions. One is the make list, create a new list containing only I. It passes as an argument to this function where I is an index for the array of quadruples. Make list return a pointer to the list it has made. And then the function merge, it will merge the P1 and P2. These are the P1 and P2 are the two pointers. It contains the list of pointed by this P1 and P2 and return a pointer to the concatenated list. Next is the backpatch P, I, insert I as the target label for each of the statement on the list pointed by P. See the backpatching using the Boolean functions. Here for this or here it will merge. It will merge the list e1.t list and e2.t list. And here, if we are using the or, here it will merge the e1.f list and e2.f list. So, in this way, using the backpatch for the Boolean function, we can also generate the three address code. Then, this is the backpatching using the flow of control statements. Next is the last topic is the procedure call. Compiler to generate good code for the procedure call and return the value. The runtime routine that handle procedure argument passing call and returns are the part of the runtime support package. Here let us consider a grammar with the simple procedure call statements. Here it will call the procedure and L equal to L, comma E, then L is E. What is the means of this? When a procedure call occurs, space must be allocated for the activation record in the call procedure. The argument of the call procedure must be evaluated and made available to the call procedure in a known place. Environment pointer must be established to enable the call procedure to access data in enclosing blocks. The state of the calling procedure must be saved so it can be resumed execution after a call. Then also saved in a known place is the return address, the location to which the call routine must transfer after it is finished. Finally, a jump to the beginning of the code for the call procedure must be generated. Then the calling sequence. Here the data structure Q is used to hold the various parameter of the procedure. Here the keyword PARM, that is the used to list the parameters, passes to get to the procedures. The call to the procedure is given by the call ID. Here ID denote the name of the procedure. Here E dot place give the value of the parameter which is inserted into the queue. For this L, E the queue gets empty, and here a single pointer to the symbol table is obtained. The pointer denotes the value of E. So these are the references, and thanks.